Hello and welcome back to another Future Doc House production. My producer has asked me to smile and be more likable, so here it is. Alright, we are continuing our journey on this book that I wrote, or this manuscript that I wrote. Check it out, download it, find me on social media and I will send you a link to it. Alright, Bacteria lives in certain, many different environments, okay? Some environments have oxygen, some environments don't have oxygen. Now, usually I would want to talk about how oxygen radicals or oxygen products affect bacteria, but I decided to talk about where bacteria live and how they, and go from there. And in the next video, I'll talk about how bacteria fights against oxygen products. All right, so there are four environments that bacteria live in. Some of them are obligate aerobes, and they live in oxygen. They use oxygen and needs oxygen, okay? They, just like us, go through the Krebs cycle or tricyclic acid cycle and TCA cycle and perform glycolysis and respiration. You should know all this stuff. But because they live in an oxygen environment, they need catalase, peroxidases, and superoxide dismutase. Now, I will explain on those long medical words later, okay? They also can live in areas, environments where there's no oxygen, like they're obligate anaerobes, and they hate oxygen. And they don't have or need any enzymes against oxygen products. So, because they, basically oxygen would be toxic for them. So, they wouldn't even bother surviving, let alone needing these enzymes to fight against oxygen products. So, those are obligate anaerobes. We also have microaerophilic types of bacteria. And these bacteria live in anaerobic environments, but they are aerotolerant. They can survive with areas with oxygen, okay? So they use fermentation predominantly, and they have, since they can live in oxygenated environments, they're gonna need some enzymes to fight against the oxygen products. But these do not have catalase, and we'll talk about that later. Facultative anaerobes, again, opposite of microaerophilic. They prefer an oxygen-rich environment, but they can also grow without oxygen by fermentation. So let's talk about some examples, shall we? First of all, the obligate aerobes, there's dozens to list, so we're not gonna talk about those. Let's talk about the ones that we can memorize, or we can at least group and figure out how to understand the bacteria that would fit into these groups and help you in your board exams, okay? All right, let's talk about obligate anaerobes. Now, these are a group of bacteria that would have to live in an environment absent of oxygen. And these bacteria causes a handful of diseases. Mainly, they cause diseases that smell bad, okay? These bacteria smell bad. They also cause necrotitis fasciitis. I can't even pronounce it. Give me 2 seconds while I look it up. Basically, flesh-eating bacteria, okay? And it's a group A streptococcus, gas group A streptococcus, and it's a flesh-eating bacteria, also known as necrotizing fasciitis. Necrotizing fasciitis. Ah, I need to learn English. All right, and that's the group A streptococcus predominantly. Now, the foul-smelling bacteria are actinomyces, bacteroides, and clostridium. Now, these bacteria, when we get into details, have a very unique foul smell. And when you think of foul-smelling bacteria, think obligate anaerobes, okay? and it will help you choose the right answer when diagnosing a patient. Facultative anaerobes, the famous one, there's lots, but let's talk about only the famous one, the one that you will probably get a question on, is E. coli, or E. coli. And E. coli is found in the gut, and so, but they also survive outside of the gut. So you will learn that they prefer an oxygen environment, but they can also grow without oxygen in the gut by fermentation. And finally, let's talk about microaerophilic bacteria. These are Vibrio, Campylobacter, Legionella, Neisseria, and Helicobacter. Helicobacteria is the one that Helicobacter pylorus found in the stomach, and it causes a lot of problems. And we will get into details about Helicobacter, but you know, in the stomach there is still oxygen, so it's microaerophilic. It is aerotolerant, but again, also predominantly uses fermentation. Okay, so that's that. We're going to discuss the enzymes that will break down the oxygen product in the next video. Again, here's my smile. If you like this video and you want more of these videos, please click subscribe. Thank you and have a nice day.
Congratulations! You are a medical student. One day, you will be a qualified doctor and your home will be a hospital or a clinic. But for now, your journey begins in the lecture hall. You will listen to countless hours of lectures and spend evening after evening in the library reading page after page of medical theory. And guess what? This is the easy part. The hardest part is retaining your medical knowledge so it's there when you need it. For example, examinations. But don't worry, we are here to help. Meet Jeff. Jeff is a good student. He goes to all his lectures. He says no to parties so he can stay late in the library. But when it's time to take the exams, Jeff freezes. The knowledge that he spent so long learning just isn't there anymore. Now meet Jennifer. Like Jeff, she is a good student. But instead of just reading textbooks late into the night, Jennifer uses technology to help her study. She also watches lectures on YouTube and practices her knowledge with QUPI, a medical quiz app and online platform. Jennifer likes QUPI because it has 10,000 practice questions covering her entire medical course. This means she can practice her medical knowledge from anywhere and in a way that actually prepares her for the exams. Because she is practicing with exam-style questions, when she takes real exams, she'll be ready. Don't be a Jeff. Begin your 7-day free trial with QUPI today.